I'm not going to dilly-dally. I just want to say this is Jerrica. She has an amazing testimony, and I'm so excited for her to share it with all of you.
Hi, my name is Jerrica Bernardo. I grew up in a Christian home with loving and supportive parents who raised me with the knowledge of Jesus Christ. We attended church every Sunday, we read the Bible, and did devotions regularly. As a child, I never really doubted my faith. I followed the lead of my parents and did as I was told. I thought that following routines and traditions were strong enough grounds to believe what I did, not realizing that Christianity needed to go deeper than that. I had no discernment or true beliefs, despite being called a Christian. I'd like to share a story that started to change all of this. When I was little, my grandfather was diagnosed with cancer. Even though I was so little, I remember that time with a painful precision. At that time, I felt pain. My pain, my family's pain, the pain of people who would possibly lose a father or grandfather. Hopelessness surrounded me. Unfortunately, he died the day before my birthday. Growing up, it never felt right to celebrate my birthday at a time so close to when my grandfather died. It reminded me of the sorrow that surrounded me, those thoughts that caused doubts and questions about my faith to flood my mind. A cloud of doubt cast a shadow of darkness on me. How could this happen? How could Jesus take his life away from us? If God has a plan, why is the world full of chaos and despair, I thought to myself. Similar to his death, these thoughts did not sit well with me. This was probably one of the first times I had doubted my faith. It was new and scary, so I bottled these thoughts and put them away. Although I grew up feeling the love of God, I became a teenager with a constant anxiety in my heart. I experienced trepidation at the prospect that I might not be accepted or liked by people that I meet, that one day I would be alone, that possibly I was wandering through my life with cluelessness, uncertainty, and a void in my heart. I often felt that I was roaming alone in darkness. The doubts that I had bottled up transformed into fears. I no longer trusted God. Because I wanted to gain a deeper understanding of my faith, I cried out for help, for the truth, for answers. God brought me to the church, to his word. I tried to understand as best as I could. During that time, as I read the word of God, I learned many stories about people in the Bible who doubted God and their faith. People who throughout the chaos had doubts like I did. As I grew older, I was slowly but surely developing a stronger faith. I was brought back to Christ. I also learned that Jesus loves his children and has a plan for everything. I may not understand his plan, and it may cause doubt, but Jesus' love is stronger than anything. I learned that I can trust him, my only savior. In my time of suffering and need, when I was at my worst, he was there for me. This does not mean that I will not experience trials and tribulations. Instead, it means that in his presence, I no longer need to fear or experience apprehension, for he protects me through them. Jesus loves and accepts me with open arms. Only he can define who I am as a child of God. I have chosen to get baptized because I believe that Jesus died on the cross as a perfect sacrifice, was resurrected from the dead, and he offers me salvation from my sins. In John 14:6, Jesus states, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Around the time of my 14th birthday, I no longer experienced doubt as I used to around that time. Instead, I chose to repent and accept Jesus in my life as my Lord and Savior. The Holy Spirit changed me and my heart. His love grows within me along with every new day, and it would be my greatest pleasure to turn my life around and live for him. In Isaiah 9:2, it says, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned." Until I accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior, I roamed alone in the darkness, but Jesus enlightened me and offered me the greatest gifts: his love, presence, peace, salvation, and spiritual healing. Thank you, and God bless.
Jerrica, have you trusted Jesus as your personal Savior?
Yes.
And do you intend to follow him for life as your Lord?
Yes.
Then based on your willing testimony, I baptize you, my sister, In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Crushed it.